We'll start again. We'll start with the head and neck region. We'll start here. And first, masseter is the cheek muscle right there. Then we have, along the mandible, we have the digastric muscles. So here's one, here's the other. They make this kind of V shape going this way. Between the digastric means two bellies because it's a muscle with two bellies. And then we have this mylohyoid, which has these transverse striations that go across horizontally. And then coming down to the sternum, we have a bunch of muscles that start with sterno. This first one is called sternomastoid, and it makes this V shape here. And here's the sternomastoid, and it goes up to the mastoid process. Then also originating from the sternum is this pair of straps that goes right on top of the trachea. This is the sternohyoid muscle, ends on the hyoid bone, and there are two of them. They're parallel to one another. Right underneath them and lateral to them, and it's eight up on this side, but here you can see it, is the sternothyroid, and it's lateral to and deep to the sternohyoid. Then going down into the thoracic muscles, we have the pectoralis major, which is this top triangle here. Then we have the pectoralis minor, which is this chevron right here, this V-shape. And then we have another V-shape right under that called ziphyhumeralis, so called because it starts at the xiphoid process and goes up into the humerus of the arm. That's where it attaches. So ziphyhumeralis, pectoralis minor, pectoralis major, and then if you hold the arms back, the pectoantibrachialis pops right out. And the pectoantibrachialis goes across the pectoral region and across the brachial region. Okay, then we can move up to the shoulder group. We have at the top of the arm the spinodeltoid here. And then we can turn the cat over. And we can remember our acronym, cats are stupendous. So we have the clavodeltoid, the acromiodeltoid right here, which is this kind of triangular shape. And then we have the spinodeltoid, which is this strap that comes up. And this strap makes an interesting angle with this, which is called the levator scapulae. And that's kind of like a backpack strap. And it separates the deltoid group from the trapezius group. And we also have the same acronym for the trapezius group. Cats are stupendous. We have the clavotrapezius. We have the acromiotrapezius, which goes across the shoulder blades, and we've cut it so we can see inside. And then we have the spinotrapezius, which is basically this triangular shape right here. So, clavotrapezius, acromiotrapezius, spinotrapezius, the levator scapulae is what separates them from the deltoid group, clavodeltoid, acromiodeltoid, spinodeltoid. All right, so then we can go into the thoracic muscles, and we'll come back to the back muscles in just a bit, but I'm following the sheet. So the thoracic muscles, we see the serratus ventralis. That's our fan blade here, and that's this one. These are bits of the serratus ventralis here, and we can pick them up and look at them individually and see them. And then if we go anterior to that, we can see scalenes. Scalenes are the ones that run longitudinally with the body axis. So these are scalenes. You don't need to differentiate which are which, just that these are scalenes. Next, we have, interestingly, we want to go back to the back again, following the sheet. We have, once we pull back the acromiotrapezius, we can see this muscle right here that's right next to the spine, that is called splenius muscle. Then we have something called rhomboideus capitis. That is this strap right here that goes from the rest of the rhomboids all the way up to the head. So we can think of it going to the cap. So this is rhomboideus capitis. If you stick it down, it'll lay on top of the splenius. But it's basically this strap muscle here. And it's part of the rhomboideus group, which is these filaments here. These are rhomboideus. All of these are rhomboideus muscles right here. So I missed subscapularis on the list, but subscapularis is this whole bit under the scapula. All of that is subscapularis. Now if you want to, and it's on the inferior part of the scapula, so it's the deep part. Now if we peel back acromiotrapezius, you can see this ridge of bone here. This is the scapular spine. On top of this, we have supraspinatus, because it's above the spine of the scapula, supraspinatus. And then we have infraspinatus. To see that, we got to pull back latissimus dorsi here. And we can see, this muscle all right here is infraspinatus. Then we have this muscle, which is teres major, and it runs the lateral border of the scapula right here. This little bit back here is actually where rhomboideus attaches. So you probably will not see rhomboideus pinned back here. You will only see it pinned here, probably. But your infraspinatus is most of this here, is this muscle, and your teres major is this muscle. Okay, so then, flipping it back on the front side, we've got to see the external intercostals. To find them, the external intercostals, we can go behind serratus ventralis. This is kind of a fatty kitty, but you see these ribs here? They're between the ribs. We might see it better on this side. Let's see. So, no dice. All full of fat over here. So some cats will see it better. I suspect they'll label it on a different cat. But there's a rib. There's a rib. There's a rib. You can see that. You can hear how it's clicking. These muscles in between the ribs are the external intercostal muscles. Okay. Now that brings us to the abdominal region. We have the external abdominal oblique. If you think of wearing a coat, this is the outside coat flap, and the fibers are running at a 45 degree down angle, like you're putting your hands in your pocket. Now if we peel back the external abdominal oblique, we can see the internal abdominal oblique, which is right here, and you see how the muscle fibers are running up, as though the exact opposite of the external abdominal oblique. These ones here, you can actually see the fibers here, and you can see how they're running in a sort of a 45 degree up angle. Then, if we peel back a little bit of the internal, this is internal abdominal oblique. I hope that's what I said. This being external, this being internal. And then if we peel back a little bit of the internal abdominal oblique, you see these transverse fibers that are running circumferentially like a belt? That is the transverse abdominis. Then we have this two sets of muscles on either side of what we call the linea alba. And the linea alba is right here. And that means white line. And then you have the rectus abdominis on either side of it. Rectus means straight, and abdominis obviously is to do with the abdomen. So rectus abdominis goes straight down the abdomen, and it follows either side of the linea alba. Okay, so then we can go up back to our arm, and we can go to the four limb muscles. We'll start on the back. We'll start with the triceps brachii. The long head is the part at the bottom of the arm, or on the posterior part of the arm here. If we look at it from the lateral side, it's kind of shiny inside, but this muscle here is the long head of the triceps brachii. Then we have the lateral head of the triceps brachii, which hasn't been fully dissected on this side, so we'll go on this side, and it's this one right here. This is the lateral head of triceps brachii, and then if we look inside, there you can see the medial head right there. You can actually see it from the other side as well, but it's usually pinned from this side. That is the medial head of the triceps brachii. Then we have the brachialis muscle, which runs right around here. So it's sort of under the clavodeltoid and above or anterior to the lateral head of the triceps brachii. Now, turning back to the front, we have the epitrochlearis, which is this thin little muscle right here, and it's epitrochlearis because it ends right around the trochlea of the ulna. So this is epitrochlearis, that's right here. And then we have brachioradialis, which is on the back again, of course, would have to be. Let's see, did we dissect it out here? Yes, we did. So it runs up into the forearm, is the only muscle you'll see running up into the forearm, and it comes from the brachial region up to the radial along the radial bone. So that's brachioradialis. And the one that I missed was biceps brachii, which is your biceps curl muscle. And it's sort of anteriorly in the same place where the brachialis is posteriorly. So it's this muscle in here. We haven't really pulled it up, but it's the one you do your biceps curls with. So it's right here. So if I pull this down, and pull the pectoral antebrachialis aside, you can see it right here. See that?